Good morning, student. Welcome to the computer class. Today I'm going to teach about how to create a cloud effect in Photoshop. So let's start. So open your Photoshop. So I'm going to open my Photoshop CS6 version. If you have Photoshop latest CC version, well and good. So let us start creating. The first thing you need to do is create a new file. So let's go. Click file, go to new. Or simply computer shortcut control N. The property box has been opened. Now let us change the dimensions. So already I have the dimensions width 10, height 7. So it looks like a rectangular box. I'm going to keep resolution 300. Always make sure you have a good resolution so that whenever you're going to print the image or save it and see the zoomed version, it looks very good. And I have selected color mode RGB 16 bit. So let us continue. Click OK. So new file has been created. So the next thing you need is a background layer. So as I told, we are going to see about how to create a cloud effect. Means you need a background layer having clouds. So let us open the background with having clouds. So there are two ways to go. Either go to file and click open, or simply use the computer shortcut control O. So let's go control O. And here I have a good cloud background effect. I'm going to open it. So click open. So we have a good background effect now. But here in this background, you can see at the bottom there is a small text, and you don't want that text. So you will use the crop tool to crop it. So select the crop tool and crop as much as you need and click OK. Good. Now the image looks very good. So like use the select marquee tool to select the image, and I selected the image. There are two ways to move this image to the our newly created file. Either use Control C and to copy and paste it there, or simply use the move tool V shortcut. So I'm using Control C option, which would be easy for you to use. So Control C, I have copied the image. Now go to the new file and paste it. Control V. So it has been pasted, but you see the image is not exactly matching to the background. So let us match it. So the thing you need to do is select the shortcut Control T, means free transform, means you are going to transform the image, you are going to fit the image. So as you selected free transform, you cannot see all the borders of the image, so you need to reduce the size. So Control plus minus, this will reduce the size. Now you can see the borders. So adjust your borders according to the background. So stretch it to your background. So now this covers everything well and good. Click OK. So let us fit it to the screen again there. So you can either press Control and plus options, or simply you can press Control O, which will fit the image to the screen. So now my background layer is ready. Now let us add the face which you want to convert into the cloud effect. So again, open the face. Now I'll show one more way to open the images. So first thing is, instead of clicking either Control or going to file and opening the file, you can directly open your browser and select the files which you have. So here I'm selecting my image, and then drag the image to your Photoshop without leaving. Go to your top panel and leave it there. See, the photo has been selected. Now for the cloud effect, I want only the face. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use quick selection tool to do selection very quickly. Or if you have want to be very precise about the selection, go ahead with the lasso tool. So I'm going to do a quick selection because the clouds won't have proper edges. So I'm good with having rough edges. But here the image is selected, but here you can see my neck also got selected, which I don't want. So I'm going to select minus in the quick selection tool and going to remove the unwanted part. This is good, but few areas got deselected. So I'm going to select again, plus again, and going to select them. Good. This is good. This is good. So we have got selected. Now simple way to do is copy the selected part and paste it there. So simply press Control C, go to your new layer and paste it. Control V. You can see the image is pasted, but it's too big to the image. So what you'll do, you need to readjust it to the background layer. So what you'll do, you'll press Control minus to reduce the size, and then select the layer to do free transformation. So select the layer. Here you can see different layers. You can see here, first thing I have a background layer, followed by the sky layer, followed by new photo. if you can't see, just click on the eye icons to hide them so that you can see different layers that has been done. So now let us select all the layers and let us pre-transform it. So the shortcut to do is Control T. So now you can see it. So let us just move a little bit up so that I can see my bottom corner. So don't forget to press Shift and then start adjusting, or else your dimensions will get distorted. As you are selecting a face, the dimension should be precise. You don't want your face to be either stretched or shrinken, right? So let us select, place it somewhere. So let us fix it to our screen. So the option is Control O shortcut. So now you need, your image has been compressed to the screen size. Now let us just adjust it in a good way where it looks very good. So I want to make it a little bit bigger. I will save and press it. So I think this place will be very good. So now the next step is to invert the colors. How you'll do it? Select the layer, go to your bottom. There you have the fourth option where you are creating new adjustment layers. So click on the adjustment layers and select invert. Okay, invert is applied, but this invert has been applied to the entire thing, but you want to be invert only to be applied to your face. So what you will do, select the invert layer, right click on it and create clipping mask. Good, but this doesn't look like exact cloud effect, right? So before doing the cloud effect, let us do one small adjustment. So go to your layer, select the invert layer and your face layer where you have, and combine it into a single file so that it's easy. Now as it converted into single file, what I did is I have selected them, right clicked and then clicked merge layers. So it got two layers have been converted into one single layer. Now before doing our changes, let us convert into a smart object. So select, right click on the layer and convert to smart object. Why smart object? Because smart object means without any disturbing the original image, you can do the adjustment. So now it is very easy. Go to your different blend modes. Blend modes are nothing but how the image should be blending with the previous or old layer. So this is normal mode. Here you have the top, click and select three. See, you can already see the photo started looking like a cloud effect. So just again, I'm going to stretch a little bit so that it will look good. Then click OK. So basically, this is basic steps to create a cloud effect. But this doesn't necessarily, you always follow the same steps in same order. In Photoshop, you can skip few steps, you can do steps different manner, and you can add few more effects. So always be creative and try to do different adjustment layers to make your photo look better. So it's time for you to go ahead and start creating your own cloud effect photo. So once you're done, don't forget to share it with us so that we all can share it with the other students. So thank you for your session. Hope you all enjoyed it. So it's time for you people to create your own cloud effect. Thank you. So before I want to close, let me just save the file. So I'll go to click file, save, and then I'm going to save in PSD file so that whenever I want, I can redesign it. So I'm going to save it in my own layer and save it. Okay. So now a PSD file will be created. So PSD file, if you want to save it as even an image file, just go to file, click save as. Instead of PSD, select your JPG. So this will save your file as a normal photo so that you can upload it or you can simply keep it as your background. So let me just, so with point here, our session has been concluded. Hope you all enjoyed it. Thank you.